Hello and welcome back to Amazing Mind. If you've just joined us, I'd like to introduce my second guest. My second guest is Dr. Judy Rosenberg. She is a psychologist who graduated from UCLA. She is also an amazing author with two of my favorite books. Her first one is called Dr. Judy's Habit Breakers. It's all about quitting smoking. And her second book, which is the one that we're going to talk about today, is called Be the Cause, Healing Human Disconnect. If Dr. Judy looks familiar, you've seen her on E! Entertainment, where she psychoanalyzes the celebrities. Please help me welcome my guest, Dr. Judy Rosenberg. Dr. Judy, you have an amazing way of healing human disconnect. You do it globally, you do it for our communities, you do it for couples, and even the individual. With your permission today, I'd like to talk about how to do it for the individual using your construct called the mind map. Can you please tell us about the mind map and how we can use it to heal human disconnect in ourselves?
Absolutely. The mind map is a pathway to healing. I'm going to talk about it from a micro perspective, and then we'll grow macro at the end.
Yes.
So the mind map is divided into three segments. It's a from, through, to model.
So past, present, and future.
Correct.
Take us with our first panel, which is called the wound.
The wounds of childhood are divided into five major wounds, and wounds of childhood shatter our perception of ourselves and the world. And there are five of them that I identified, and of course there are more, five main ones. Physical abuse, sexual abuse, verbal abuse, emotional slash verbal abuse, neglect and smothering.
And what does this do to impact us in our past, in our childhood?
These wounds disconnect us from our primary caregivers. So starting with mother-infant disconnect, father-infant disconnect, then a disconnection from family, a disconnection from community, and eventually we end up with a very fractured humanity.
How do we react to these wounds?
Well, because these injuries take place on a pre-verbal level, first few months and years of life, we don't have words to really translate these hurts, so we react by primitive ways based on fight-flight syndrome, the fight-flight system, which is the amygdala center in the brain.
Which gives us anxiety, and it can give us aggression too.
Aggression, anxiety, shutting down, psychosomatic ways of experiencing this disconnect.
Like asthma, headaches, stomach issues, anything
yes.
we feel in the physical body.
Yes.
I love this graphic. Tell me about how this encodes. And here it shows our actual DNA.
Yes, this is a biological model that I translated into a psychological model. And this encoding is the end game of the wounds of childhood in the sense of how we encode it into the fiber of our being. And this relates to negative core beliefs, such as, for example, if your father called you stupid or treated you like you're stupid, then you would encode in there, I'm stupid. I will never amount to much.
So that rolls us right into how this impacts us in the present.
So what happens is that this here, panel three, our encoding, is our trigger point. It's our Achilles heel. And life triggers us, relationships, bosses, our children, the news. We get triggered, and when we're triggered, and we're triggered specifically in our negative core belief, we then end up in what I call the WTF zone,
which WTF, is- WTF, what does that mean?
Exactly, exactly. Well, it's the repeat Freudian, WTF with the Freud, the repeat pattern that occurs because we're triggered and we're recapitulating the pattern of breaking down, defending, and at the end having a major breakdown, or the bottoming out, as you said.
So yeah, because in the 12-step program, we call that hitting rock bottom.
Yes.
So when we hit rock bottom, it can be a huge crisis, but it can also be an opportunity.
Yes.
How can we use this to activate the healing fields?
in the mind map therapy, we decode our past so that we can recode our future. And part of decoding the past is to go back into the wounds of childhood, identify them, locate the core beliefs that keep us stuck in our way of seeing ourselves in the world. And then we enter in this phase of our work into what I call truth conversations designed to get the psychological poison out of our system.
So the same way that a doctor or a surgeon could lance a boil,
yeah,
or lance an infection to,
yes,
let the poisons out,
yes,
we can do that in a therapeutic hour. Well,
right,
not 1 hour, but many therapeutic hours.
Yes.
We have with us in our studio audience and those of us watching at home, we have many hypnotherapists, psychotherapists, clergy, other people who are, might even be interested in healing ourselves.
Yes.
Can you talk about how we would use our time being mental health workers? What would it look like in our private practice to help people with that wound?
Well, because of the simplicity of the mind map, it speaks to children, adults, and people of different cultures. So step number one is to locate these childhood wounds. Step number two is to understand the encoding that occurs and bust the lie, because these lies that land as our negative core beliefs are just that. They're our belief systems based on what our parents teach us we are in the world.
I want to take this step by step, because I certainly know how to be a witness to someone's story. I know how to be unconditionally, see each client with unconditional positive regard.
Yes.
Is it more, Dr. Judy, than just being a witness to our client's pain?
Yes, it's more than that, because we have to reopen these wounds. We have to deliberately, with permission from our clients, go into these wounds so that, number one, they can see who done it, what happened, what it sounded like, and then do reparative work. So phase one would be activating the wound. Phase two would be neutralizing the wound. And then phase three would be resetting the boundaries, reconnecting to the truth and the light, and developing our authentic selves based on new boundaries and new encodings.
Teach us, starting with number one, how do we, deep breath, reactivate the wounds in the therapeutic room, which is a sacred space?
Okay, so in this sacred space, for example, if you were my client, I would understand what your negative core belief is, and then I would enter into activating that by purposefully recreating a conversation that would activate your amygdala and your reactions.
So are we doing role playing where you,
yes,
would be?
Yes,
father?
I would be your mother, your father.
Can I use a real life example that has to do with me?
Please
so we
do.
Can all understand this?
Please do.
I was told, first of all, I was an unwanted pregnancy. That was never a secret. But if I was going to be born, I didn't even have the good sense to be a boy. I was supposed to be Lee David, not Lisa Ruth.
Okay.
So if I disclose that to you, and that is a primary wound,
yes,
how would you activate it?
I might activate it by playing your parental figure.
It would be my father. My mother,
okay,
not so much, but my father was very disappointed I was born and not a boy.
I would enter into a conversation of how disappointed I am in you.
Wow.
Yeah, and that would definitely trigger your negative core belief, so that the therapist would be playing two roles. In essence, reactivating the wound and standing as an enlightened witness to the truth of what happened.
Two roles. You're an,
yes,
enlightened witness to the pain, and you are activating it.
Yes.
And we're not talking about Gestalt, Dr. Judy. We're not yelling at empty chairs.
Nope. No.
This
the
is
full
life.
Chair.
Full
I'd,
chair.
I'd be sitting here. Yeah.
And hypnotherapists can certainly do it with eyes open or eyes closed,
yes,
with a form of hypnodrama.
Yes.
So you are activating the wound by saying, Lisa, you shouldn't have been born. And if you were born, you should have been Lee David.
Correct.
And then, so I understand that. And show me how to be the enlightened witness.
So you would then be hearing the ridiculousness of the conversation, because there would be a piece of you that would be standing at arm's distance going, wow, that sounds pretty crazy,
yes,
now that I see it that way. And then the next piece of it would be neutralizing it by you speaking your truth to the parent, with who would then have to be quiet and listen and take in how that encoded in you and how that made you feel. And then the last piece of it would be for you to push back against your parent.
So we certainly need lots of tissues when we're doing this exercise.
Yes.
Because we're going to get right into those primary wounds.
Absolutely.
And how do we listen as that parent, as our client, with the best of his or her adult self, pushes back? What does that look like?
When the child or the adult child pushes back, the best place to be in that position is really quiet and to take it in. In some cases, the parent is obviously so damaged and so self-involved that they're not able to take in what the child has to say, and you have to address that part of the truth. So it is true, the truth will set the person free.
So just to clarify, you're acting as the good parent. You become the parent who creates the wound, and then can listen with a whole heart, with all six senses,
yes,
as Sigmund Freud say, with equally hovering attention.
Yes.
What the Freud?
Yes.
We listen with equally hovering attention, and we are the good parent who's able to hear the truth and respond with love and knowledge and acceptance and accountability to our client's truth.
Yes, because the damaged parent can never do this work. The hurter cannot be the healer. So that we have to take that position of healing our clients through giving them an experience to close that psychological file so that they don't have to go through the WTF, the spin cycle.
Over and over again.
Yes.
And how does the client then react in his or her world, once we've gone through the past, the present, and activating the healing field for the future?
First of all, there is a clear lens of perception because they're no longer buying into that lie. Instead of identifying with the lie, they can identify the lie. So that's a very large piece of it. The second piece of it is that they can now grow because they're not going to be stuck in lies and stuck in defense mechanisms and spinning around in chaos and breakdowns. And so now they can reset their boundaries. They could start recoding themselves based on truth, and they can build a more sustainable foundation that can then attract people into their lives that are going to treat them according to their new boundaries and according to their new level of esteem.
So you're actually attracting new people, healthier people,
yes,
that see the truth and don't reflect the great lie.
Correct.
Dr. Judy, you taught us how to do this on the individual level. It looks like we're almost out of time, but if you would like to learn how to use this method for yourself, for your clients, for people in relationships, at work, romantic relationships, friendships, sibling groups, or even to heal the human disconnect of the world, please feel free to get Dr. Judy Rosenberg's book, Be the Cause, Healing Human Disconnect, which is available on Amazon.com. Everyone's going to want to come in and learn more about this. And I know you have your private practice here in beautiful Southern California.
Yes.
Can you give us your website?
Yes, I'd be happy to, and thank you for the opportunity. It's www.psychologicalhealingcenter.com.
Well, I want to thank you, Dr. Judy Rosenberg, for being a guest on the show and sharing your education, expertise, and experience. I want to thank all of you in the studio audience and those of you watching at home. My name is Lisa Mackenberg, and I hope you'll stay tuned. We have a lot more coming up for you on hypnosistv.com. That's hypnosistv.com. 24/7.
Thank you very much for the opportunity.
Thank you.